Darlene Vincent is no stranger to cooking. It's a skill she perfected while growing up in Trinidad, learning to cook from her mom when she was just 12 years old.
She used to sell at different events, parties, carnival. I'm from a family of 12, and we all had to cook growing up. It was hard, but, you know, we did it.
But Vincent soon understood she had a gift for making people smile through food. So she used that passion to earn an income and provide for her three children, continuing her culinary journey when she moved to New York in 1996.
I started off cooking in a one room.
Yeah.
And I just moved on from there for different events and parties, selling for myself, apple pies. Because I wasn't working, I was not documented as yet, so I had to get a meaner income. So I started selling food to the hair salons and the barber shops.
Nearly 30 years later, Vincent is infusing her love for cooking into her own catering business, Tanty Darlene's Kitchen. It's an ode to her Trinbagonian culture, serving traditional dishes like bacon shark and aloo pies, as well as a meal Vincent says is one of her specialties, curry crab and dumpling.
It's good. I cook it good. It's one of our dishes back home. Our country is Trinidad and it's made up of a twin island state. So in Tobago, this is like one of the main dishes that they use at home. And we use it in Trinidad as well.
Now Vincent spends her Friday evenings cleaning and seasoning large bowls of crab in preparation to serve her specialty dish at Smorgasburg Prospect Park. As one of the newest vendors to be accepted into the popular seasonal food festival, finding out Tanty Darlene's Kitchen would have a spot every Sunday left Vincent and her family overcome with emotion, as captured in this video.
It felt great because I feel like my mom is known in the Trinidadian, the Trinbagonian community, you know, as this person that cooks food. But I want the world to know her. I want the world to know her. So it felt great knowing that she'll be at Smorgasburg. This is major.
Afisha Chung remembers being by her mother's side when she would walk up and down Brooklyn selling food.
I don't know how my mom got introduced to the people at the salons, but we would go to the salons with this little trolley cart and sell food.
A flight attendant by day, Chong says she never really had an interest in taking part in the food business. But when her sister Letitia passed away 2 years ago, all of that changed.
My sister always pushed for my mom to just put herself out there. So my sister will have events just for people to come and eat my mom's food. She was a hairstylist, so she had a lot of just celebrity friends and people in her industry that supported her. So they would come to my mom events and eat her food. So with that, those same people started support. When my sister passed, those people started supporting my mom in a major way. So they'll help design my mom's logo, her branding for her tent. And yeah, so we're here because of them too.
Today, Tanty Darlene's Kitchen is a full family affair with Vincent's daughters and other loved ones helping out, fitting as the word Tanty, a term of endearment for auntie widely used in the Caribbean, symbolizes a familiar style of cooking.
And I feel proud of her. That's how they are, the siblings. Everybody feel proud of her. They do, you know? And we are to come and support her every time. Whatever little help we can give, we are there.
All right, guys, so you know I could not leave here without trying it myself, right?
Tanty Darlene put her foot in this, boy. It also has become a customer favorite here, with the food selling out every weekend. A spokesperson for Smorgasburg saying, it's been a pleasure to welcome Tanty Darlene's Kitchen into the Smorgasburg vendor community for her team's incredible energy, personal story, and of course, delicious food.
It brings joy to my heart because she came here as an immigrant. She started food sales. She used to do curry-cues, barbecues, and then she'd do a lot of catering. And then when she got the opportunity to come to Smorgasburg, it was just a joy to the family.
I never thought I would have been here. But again, when your food is good, you know, you have to expect and take for, you know, in heed that, yeah, your food is good, so you gotta be here. And I'm here, I'm grateful for being here.
A journey of determination turned into success, proving anything truly is possible. I'm Melissa Rose Cooper, and thank you for sharing with Mel.
Thanks for watching, guys, and if you enjoyed this video and want to show your support for more like it, you can simply buy me a coffee. All the details are in the description.